Have a couple more of these. Use again, use again, use again. Tell you what, have a couple of these as well. Speed your healing. Is it up to 100% yet? Near death, 28%. So, a couple more of these, yeah. Oh. Well, there we go. Owen's just about back to normal. Right, well, that was a lot of time and money spent just to get us back where we were. Yeah, we're going in again. We need to go back into Sildin anyway to talk to people. Tavern. Right then. James paused. Though he thought to get the man's attention, he decided he was... This is not the first time I've read anything today. He decided he was far more interested in what the man was whispering to a mercenary who was seated nearby. Well, who has the crawler's key, then? The man shrugged. Kivo dropped it in the scramble out the sewers after they did in the upright man. None of us had the desire to stick around about any longer. Mockers were right, mad. So it's still in the sewers, is it? Unless one of the Mockers boys picked it up, I'd say so, yes. Not like it matters what with the crawler crawled away to Sunset Isles. Disturbed, James slipped away from the conversation. Though it was possible the men were bandying about things overheard from a rumour-monger, the demise of the upright man in Krondor would have far-reaching implications both for the kingdom and for himself. Who was the upright man? I can't remember. Well, he's a horizontal man now if he's dead. James motioned to the figure across the room. The man walked over to join them. He stood before them, eyebrows arched inquisitively. As the keeper of a tavern, I imagine you get quite a bit of traffic through here. Lots of people wanted to buy or sell items that were, shall we say, indiscriminately acquired. Who would I speak to if my interests lay in that direction? Joftas. Any that walks the streets, Sildin is not known for its reputable patronage, as you no doubt have seen. Why would this interest you? I need to find out about the possible purchase of two very special items that might have been picked up here in Sildin. Yes, the spider and the spyglass, that's what we're trying to solve, is the mystery behind the spider and the spyglass, which has got something to do with the murder of all those soldiers up in Romney, in the inn. Yes. If an item is sold in Sildin, then I'm the only man that you should speak to. Any other transaction are done the Sildin way. Very well, Joftas. I need to find out what you may know about either a brass spyglass or a silver spider. I would be willing to pay in gold. You will pay most undoubtedly for that information, but I am not interested in your kingdom coins. If it were gold, I could come up with the sum I want myself. No. What I require is the assistance of a thief. Why do you think I would be of any help? I live in a city of thieves. I've spent my life knowing how to sense them, and I know most assuredly that you have a thief's instinct. This is the bargain. I will tell you about the silver spiders that I sell on occasion, and you will find a bag of powder that was stolen by the crawler. It has most likely been taken to his house near here. The house is locked, and I suspect that the pouch will be hidden away in a chest or cabinet or such. Any thief could do that for you. Why would we be especially qualified for this? Because all the thieves in this place, they are the hands of the eye and eyes of the crawler. To be working for me, that would be the death of them. Why, what is it that is in that powder bag? I have made my offer, the information for the pouch. Do we have a deal? Yes. Where's the house? My bump of trouble. Where is your bump of trouble? Have you got a disfigurement that you haven't told us about? My bump of trouble is telling me that I just got lost there for a minute, but that I shouldn't be agreeing to this. But you have a deal, Joftas, and I'll get your pouch. A straight exchange, the information for the item. Consider it a deal then. I will wait for you here in the anchorhead until you return with the item. We will be back. Do not leave this place. Right, but where is this bloke's house then? Right, are we supposed to just know? I'll talk to him. Hello. The man grumbled. Not sure whether the comment was an invitation or an indication they should leave, James approached the man cautiously. Good day. Good day, my arse. Damn madness, all this guild feuding. He spat, wiping ale from his lips with the back of his hand. I had a regular job before all this madness began up in Romney. Now I have to do my job under the cover of night. If Arley Steelsoul would come to the negotiation table with the rest of the guilds, we could bring this idiocy to a halt. Has anybody talked to him? James asked. Who can? The man replied. He's got himself sealed up in his house near Sloop. None of the Duke of Romney's men have been able to get through to him. He won't even allow his supplies to be delivered to his door anymore. Has them dropped off in a box? Yes, we saw that, didn't we, in one of the previous videos. Serve him right if someone sent in a pack of rations that had been sitting in the sun a month more. Oh, is that why they're selling spoiled rations here? I wonder. Arrogant bastard. How much it cost for me to harbour my flats now? 100 sovereigns every 2 weeks. Despite James's repeated attempts to steer the conversation into a more interesting direction, the man insisted on relating his docking fees at the various points along the river, and the outrageous lengths to which he had to resort to deliver his goods unmolested. At last, the effect of the ale beginning to overwhelm him, he slumped against the wall and began to snore. So, yes, when we go back up to Sloop, we have to remember to buy some spoiled rations from Mrs. Woman here and pop them in the chest. If we talk to him, you're Jeff Taz, aren't you? Who are you? You're to make a stay in the inn. Right, okay. So, let's exit. Is there anywhere else we can go here? Shop. Tavern. Enter the ship. Right. Should we go on the ship? Do we have to go on the ship? No. Let's exit. And look for a house. A locked up house, apparently. I'm sure there was a house not so far away. Didn't we see one as we came past this way to avoid those things in the road? I could be mistaken. And I am. Oh, there's a house. Is this the house? I don't know. Oh, no. It's a shame you haven't got a journal in here. There isn't one, is there? It's not here somewhere. No. Preferences, contents, what's that do? I don't know. Oh, the spyglass and the spider. Are you going to tell me what I'm supposed to be doing? What? Don't start again! So you can go back and restart the chapter that way. Right, okay. Well, that would be handy if we wanted to go back and restart the chapter. Hello there, yeah, come on, click. They are here. Yes, come on. I need to reload now, don't I? Oh no, it just shows you the cutscene. So, that's for bookmarking. Is that where we've just been? Must be. Yes, we must have just been there. Yeah, I can't see any other houses at the moment. I think I'll actually call it a session there. I need to think about what we're going to do now, where we need to go. I'll probably just look it up on the internet. I won't do any thinking at all. I'll just cheat. But, you know, saying that somebody lives in a house nearby is not particularly specific, is it? Really? I mean, you could just wander around for days. Days getting lost, like this. Not knowing where you are. Except I think we are going back to Sloop at the moment. Yeah, anyway. Yeah, I'll leave it there for now and come back hopefully with more of an idea about what we're supposed to be doing later on.